Think about the air you're breathing right now. Did you know that the oxygen in the air is partly thanks to the rainforests thousands of miles away? Even though you might never visit a rainforest, your life is connected to them in ways you can't imagine. Today, we're heading deep into the world's largest tropical rainforest, the Amazon. Picture this, over 2 million square miles of dense vegetation, winding rivers, and wildlife so diverse that we're still discovering new species every year. What's truly amazing is that despite covering only about 6% of the Earth's land surface, the Amazon produces around 20% of the world's oxygen. That's why people often call it the lungs of the Earth. I wonder, what environmental conditions exist here? And how are all of these diverse species adapted for this environment? Let's explore. The Amazon rainforest is located in South America. This massive region spans across 9 different countries, but most of it is located in Brazil. Based on the Amazon's location on the map, pause and make a prediction. What type of climate does the Amazon rainforest have? Tropical! The Amazon rainforest is close to the equator, where direct sunlight leads to consistent heat transfer in the atmosphere. The Amazon rainforest is warm year-round and humid, just like you'd expect in a tropical region. High temperatures mean the water cycle moves quickly here. As trees release water vapor into the air, it comes back down as rain. Lots of rain, over 100 inches per year. No wonder they call it a rainforest. Rain is obviously an important part of the hydrosphere, but where does all that water come from? There's another major water feature in the Amazon rainforest. Can you see it cutting across the land in this map? The Amazon River is the lifeblood of this rainforest. It's the second longest river in the world, stretching over 4,000 miles. During the rainy season, the river swells and floods huge parts of the forest. These flooded forests, known as vazia, replenish the soil of the rainforest and create biodiversity hotspots. Some animals, like the Amazon river dolphin, swim among the trees with its pinkish hue and flexible neck. This mysterious and rare dolphin navigates the submerged forests, catching fish and moving through the dense roots with ease. With heavy rainfall and a powerful, sweeping river, how do you think water impacts the geosphere in the Amazon rainforest? Weathering and erosion from natural forces have a huge impact on the landscape here, forming the Amazon sedimentary basin. This basin is one of the largest in the world and has formed over millions of years. Rivers and floods carry sediments from the nearby Andes Mountains down to the basin. These deposits enrich the area, helping plants and trees grow. Essentially, the basin acts like a giant reservoir, storing water, minerals, and nutrients over time and slowly releasing them back into the ecosystem. This supply of nutrients from the mountains is super important because there's a ton of life to support here in the Amazon rainforest. In fact, most of these nutrients are absorbed so quickly by plants that the soil itself is nutrient poor. When leaves fall, they decompose rapidly, and their nutrients are swiftly recycled back into the ecosystem. This constant recycling of nutrients is what keeps the lush rainforest ecosystem thriving. Abiotic factors in the hydrosphere, atmosphere, and geosphere make the Amazon one of the most biodiverse places on Earth. With a high number of plants and trees, this ecosystem has high productivity, supporting millions of species. Competition in the rainforest is high, so in order to survive, organisms need to have adaptations for very specific niches. Luckily, the Amazon rainforest has plenty of space available. The tallest trees here can reach 200 feet. That's nearly the height of the Statue of Liberty. There are four different layers in the Amazon rainforest. You can think of the Amazon rainforest as a multi-story building, with each layer hosting distinct communities of plants, animals, and other organisms. Sunlight, humidity, and temperature vary greatly from the forest floor to the treetops, creating unique environments in each layer. Organisms in these layers are specially adapted to thrive in their specific conditions. Pause the video here and predict, based on the different abiotic factors, what kinds of adaptations will help organisms survive in each of these layers. Be sure to use this diagram in your notes to help you brainstorm. Let's take a closer look at each layer of the Amazon rainforest. As we move through each layer, fill out this chart in your lesson notes. At the very top, we have the emergent layer. This layer gets a lot more sunlight than the darker layers below and is often windy because there are no trees to block the wind. Giant kapok trees tower over other vegetation, stretching up to the sky to gather as much sunlight as possible in a crowded jungle. The emergent layer is also home to birds of prey, like the harpy eagle. This predator flies above the forest looking for food. Short wings and strong talons allow it to navigate through the trees and snatch prey like monkeys and sloths. Its incredible grip strength not only helps it grab its food, but it also helps the harpy eagle grab tight to tree branches, even on the windiest day. Just below the canopy layer forms a thick, continuous cover of leaves and branches. This is where the majority of the rainforest's wildlife lives, including birds, monkeys, frogs, and countless insects. The sloth spends most of its life in this layer, moving very slowly through the dense branches to conserve energy. While the sloth uses the dense tree cover and slow movements to hide from predators, some species have taken camouflage to a whole new level. Meet the potu bird. With its gray, mottled feathers, this ghost bird blends in perfectly with branches. When threatened, it remains perfectly still, mimicking a broken branch to avoid detection by predators. Below the canopy is the understory. This layer is shady. Less sunlight can reach past the taller canopy. This also means this layer is especially humid, as less sunlight leads to less evaporation. Instead of blending in, some species here have adapted to stand out from the crowd. The poison dart frog uses bright colors to warn away predators in the dim light. This layer also hosts the heliconia plant. With bright, bird-attracting flowers, this plant has adapted to attract hummingbirds. Its unique shape provides hummingbirds with nectar, who in turn help pollinate this plant. This flowering plant also has a thick, waxy coating on its leaves, helping shed excess water in this layer's humidity. Finally, the forest floor is where decomposition happens rapidly. Fallen leaves, fruits, and dead animals break down quickly, returning nutrients to the soil that are quickly absorbed by tree roots. Remember, the soil covering the forest floor is low in nutrients. Some species here have adapted to access these nutrients another way, stealing them from other organisms. Rafflesia, the world's largest flower, blooms here. Because of the lack of nutrients in the soil, this parasitic plant has no roots. It's adapted to steal nutrients directly from a host vine. To help with pollination, it attracts flies with its foul, rotting smell. This is also where the cordyceps fungus works its creepy magic. This parasitic fungus is known for its gruesome life cycle, where it infects insects like ants. Once inside the insect, the fungus takes over the host's body and nutrients, eventually growing out of it and releasing spores to spread to other insects. This adaptation helps the fungus thrive in the nutrient-poor environment. Wow, we explored a ton of cool species, and that was only a few of the millions of species that the Amazon rainforest supports. But human activities are threatening this important hub of biodiversity. Logging, agriculture, and mining lead to deforestation. When trees in the Amazon are cut down, they can't produce oxygen anymore, and the species that live in the canopy layers are displaced. These activities can lead to habitat destruction, biodiversity loss, climate change, and the disruption of indigenous communities that call the Amazon home. In the Amazon, each layer is a world of its own, with species specially adapted to survive in their particular niche. From the nutrient-poor soil on the forest floor to the wind and sunlight of the emergent layer, species in each layer have adapted to their own specialized role in this highly competitive, biodiverse rainforest. Whether it's overcoming biotic factors like predation or abiotic factors like humidity, rainfall, and poor soil, the adaptations here showcase the resourcefulness of life in one of the planet's most complex and challenging ecosystems. Until next time, remember, the biosphere is all around us, so keep diving into this web of life and exploring its wonders. Stay curious, keep asking questions, and I'll see you next time. Hey.